South Korean President Yoon Suk-yeol departs for the United States for a summit with President Joe Biden as he grapples for countermeasures to North Korea's evolving nuclear and missile threats. The trip is a first state visit to the U.S. by a South Korean leader in 12 years and will mark the 70th anniversary of the two countries' alliance. The two leaders are expected to explore ways to improve joint responses to deter North Korea, which has ramped up weapons development. Yoon has been pushing to boost Seoul's say in operating the American nuclear umbrella protecting its allies. A recent poll showed 54% of respondents believe the U.S. would not risk its safety to protect its Asian ally. More than 64% meanwhile support South Korea developing its own nuclear weapons. Australia eyes its biggest offense overhaul since World War II, citing China's military buildup and its threats to regional security. After acknowledging that the United States is no longer the unipolar leader of the Indo-Pacific, the government commissioned review urged Australia to take a first principles approach in avoiding the prospect of major conflict within the region. The review noted that Australia should prioritize its long-range strike capabilities to deter enemies before they reach the country's shores. It also recommended the government increase funding for defense and manufacture munitions domestically. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese says the review would aid Australia in becoming more self-reliant and secure in the years to come.
This represents a document for today and tomorrow. It is the most significant work that's been done since the Second World War, looking in a comprehensive way at what is needed. It demonstrates that in a world where challenges to our national security are always evolving, we cannot fall back on old assumptions. We must build and strengthen our security by seeking to shape the future rather than waiting for the future to shape us.
The Philippines and China seeking to establish more lines of communication to resolve any issues in the West Philippine Sea. That statement coming from Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. following his meeting with Chinese State Councilor and Foreign Minister Qin Gang in Malacanang. Marcos hailed the three-day visit of the Chinese official as very useful. He said Filipino and Chinese officials were able to iron out several miscommunications between the two parties. Qin's visit comes days after Chinese ambassador to the Philippines, Wang Qilian, drew public ire over his perceived threat against overseas Filipino workers in Taiwan. Russia claims progress in the battle for Bakhmut. Moscow's defense ministry says its forces had secured two blocks in western districts of the key Ukrainian city, while airborne units were providing reinforcements to the north and south. But a top Ukrainian commander asserted his troops were holding the front line throughout the city. Ukraine President Volodymyr Zelensky vows to keep defending Bakhmut. Russia sees the city as a stepping stone to more advances in eastern Ukraine. It has for months been the target of major attacks and has seen the heaviest fighting in the nearly 14-month war. Meanwhile, Russia says it will expel over 20 German diplomats in a tit-for-tat move following the alleged mass expulsion of Russian diplomats in Germany. Moscow has also notified Berlin that it will significantly limit the maximum number of employees in German diplomatic missions in Russia. A German tabloid has reported 34 of 90 German diplomats in Moscow have been told to leave.